Cross-legged position. Hands to the center. Closing our eyes. Sound of Om. Vajrasana. Hands in a fist with your thumbs inside and your fists are at your thigh joint. As you breathe out, slowly going into a forward bend. Breathing in to come up. Once more. And once more. For the next three cycles, just try and stay down a little longer. I'll tell you when to start coming up. Slowly breathing out to go down. Once you're down, hold the breath out and stay down. Inhale to come. Once more. Inhale to come up. Hands interlaced, push the arms up. Straighten the elbows. Relaxing the arms down. Downward dog. Bend the knees. Straighten the knees. Once more. Bend the knees. Straighten the knees. Once more. Downward dog. Getting the right leg to the front outside your right hand. And I'm going to keep my left knee straight, but I'm going to go down onto my elbows. Sometimes also known as a lizard posture. Just a strong opening of the thigh joint. Also, a lot of the stomach becomes active in this posture. Coming up, change left leg out to the left side of the left hand, and then coming down onto your elbows. Right knee remains straight. Coming up, downward dog. Once more. Relax. Vajrasana. Left arm to the front, right arm crosses from down. And then your fingers will try and touch the palm of the other hand. Okay, keeping the arms in the middle. So left arm is up, right arm crosses from down. Change. Right arm up, left arm crosses from down. and relax. Standing position. Feet hip distance away from each other. Arms up. And hips down, chair. Coming up. Feet in a V shape. Arms up. As you breathe out, forward bend. Inhale and head up. Exhale, head down. Continue. Coming up, relax the arms now. Warrior. Bend your left knee, left hand onto the ground, right arm coming over. This is difficult. You can just keep your arm rested on the thigh. Letting all of you can go down full. Coming up to the other side. Right arm down, left arm over. Coming up, feet, 2 feet away from each other, Trikonasana, right foot to the right, narrow Trikonasana. Left arm up, looking up towards the thumb, right knee straight. Left arm down, right arm up. Looking up towards the right thumb, coming into a twist. Right arm down. Left arm up. Change. Trikonasana to the left side. Right arm down, left arm up, reverse Trikonasana. Left arm down. Right arm up, coming up, relax the arms. Cat position, curl the toes in, keep the hips up, stretch your arms out to the front, forehead on the ground. Slowly coming up. Virasan, hips in between your heels. And then slowly we make our way down to a back bend. Let the arms go behind. Keep your hips tight. Slowly coming up. So little advanced postures. If you are not able to do full, also it's fine. Relax the legs to the front. And relax for a few moments. Cow. Left leg crosses from down. Right from up. Right arm from up, left arm from down. Left leg, left arm, come up. And relax. Lie down on your back. Shavasana. Right leg up. The help of your arm, hold the right thigh and pull it in. Slowly dropping it to the left side. Okay, so keeping it straight, dropping it to the left. The other leg just remains straight at the knee. My arm is going outside and my head turns to the right. So from a single leg raise, coming into a twist by just dropping it to the opposite side. My right arm is out like a wing. My head is looking to the right. While my left knee tries to remain straight. Right leg coming up and drop it back down. Left leg up straight. Hold it either the thigh or the calf. And with the help of your arms, pull the leg in. Slowly dropping the leg to the opposite side, left arm coming out to the left side, head to the left. Really beautiful twist. Left leg coming up. Relax the leg down. Turn your body to the left side. And then side leg raise. Hold your big toe over your calf and pull the leg in. Slowly relax, change. Relax. Lie down onto your back. Legs up and hold your feet with your hands, baby posture. Settle the knees down. And relax. We're going to keep our hands on the ground and we're going to do a leg raise, but only to 30 degrees. You just get your legs up 30 degrees, keep your toes pointed, and we hold this posture. Relax. Shavasana. Hugging your knees in. Hands interlaced around your shins, Pavan Muktasana. Head up. Relax the head down. Getting ready for the inversion, Sarvangasana. First, we're going to go into Sarvangasana. Sarvangasana with a split, and then we're going to go into Halasana. So legs up off the ground. Get your feet into a namaste. If you don't understand, you can come out of Sarvangasana and see it. But don't turn your neck while you're in Sarvangasana. And split. Still keeping the back straight. Straight knees. Coming up. And then Halasana. Interlace your hands. Stretch them out towards the ground. Slowly coming down to Shavasana. Getting ready for Chakrasana. Going into the full bridge. Any new ones, just go into the half bridge by just getting your hips up. All the others going into a full bridge. Chakrasana. Coming down. Feet together, drop your knees to the sides. Right knee to the right, left knee to the left. Hands on your stomach as you rest. Slowly getting the knees to come up. We're going to end with a twist. Again, lying down twist. Arms open to the sides like wings. Drop your legs to the left. Head to the right. Change. To the center. Shavasana. Relax. Awareness in the middle of your eyebrows. So there is an empty glass. This chakra, the center, is already an empty glass. And with every breath, you're filling it with a nice blue liquid. Dark blue, indigo almost. Every breath that goes in slowly, the amount of the liquid here increases. Awareness in the throat. Light blue. Slowly, as you breathe in, you start to fill the glass in the center. The blue healing liquid. And slowly, slowly in your visualization, try and fill this glass fully. Awareness in your heart. Similarly here, the color of the liquid is green here. Navel, orange, I'm sorry, yellow, filling this with a yellow color liquid. Reproductive center. Now orange. Mediterranean, red. Slowly, little movement into your fingers, a little gentle movement into your toes, turning the body to the right side. We start to come up. Just sit in the cross-legged position. Kapalbhati. Strong exhalations through the nose. Slowly breathing into the nose. Lock the throat. Gently pull the stomach in, lower lock while you hold the breath in. Unlock the locks from down to up. Slowly breathing out. Now hold the breath out and lock again. All three locks. And I'll make the stomach lock a little tighter because there's no breath inside. Unlock, inhale. You must hold for as long as possible. That's obviously a better practice, but it should still be comfortable. You're not choking with the breath and becoming uncomfortable. There's none, that'll work against you. Kapalbhati. Start. Breathing in slowly. Lock and hold. All three locks. Unlock all the locks from down to up and exhale. And as you finish exhaling, lock again. Unlock, inhale. Actually, whenever I do all the three locks, really my focus is on the stomach lock. The lower and the throat will be gentle only. They will not be so tight. Stomach is what I really contract, especially when I'm holding the breath out. Last cycle. Kapalbhati, start. Breathing out, sorry, breathing in slowly. Locks. And all the three locks will be nice and mild. Keep holding the breath in. Unlock from down to up and slowly exhale. And when you finish breathing out, three locks again. Tighten the stomach a little more. Try and hold this. Unlock, inhale. Three Mahabandhas. Breathing out strongly through the mouth. Lock the throat. Lock the stomach, lower lock. Unlock, inhale. Once more. I'm locking here. All the women on your cycles, though I would say that my experience with students for most of you should not be a problem, but if it is causing any discomfort, then you go easy on the locks. Once more. I'm locking it. These are like coming up, getting ready for. Vajrasana, knee slightly away. So I'm gonna breathe out, lock, hold the breath out. Stomach in, release, in, release, in, release, in, release. Okay, Kapalbhati, but I'm not breathing. My breath is kept outside. I'm breathing out through the mouth. Lock and stop. Stomach in, release, continue. Unlock and relax. Once more, breathing out through the unlock and inhale. This practice is called Agnisara. I hold my breath out and then I just flap the stomach in and out, like Kapalbhati. One more time. Lock the throat, hold the breath out, and start your Agnisara. Unlock and relax. Siddhasana. Anulom-Vilom. Breathing in from the left nostril. Right out. Right in. Left out. Continue. One last cycle after this. Once you finish breathing out from the left nostril, you will stop. The Ujjayi breath, breathing in and out from your nostrils with a throat sound. Any new ones who'll be following the recording, just breathe in and breathe out from your nose. We're going to breathe in 5 counts, and we're going to breathe out slower in 10 counts. Breathing in, 2, 3, 4, 5. Breathing out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In. 2, 3, 4, 5. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Breathing in. 2, 3, 4, 5. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, in, 2, 3, 4, 5, out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, in, 2, 3, 4, 5, out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This time you're going to breathe in and hold the breath. Breathing in, 2, 3, 4, 5, lock the throat. By just getting the chin down and hold the breath in, 2, 3, 4, 5, and locking out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, in, 2, 3, 4, 5, lock only the throat, holding the breath in, 2, 3, 4, 5, and locking out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, in. Lock and hold. Out. In. 2, 3, 4, 5. Lock and hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. And locking out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One more cycle. 2, 3, 4, 5. Lock and hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, and lock it out. 2, 3, 4. This time you're going to finish, and you're also going to hold the breath out. So first, breathing in. 2, 3, 4, 5, lock and hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, breathing out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then lock the throat, hold the breath out. 2, 3, 4, 5. Unlock, breathing in. 2, 3, 4, 5. Lock and hold the breath in. 2, 3, 4, 5. And lock and out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lock and hold out. 2, 3, 4, 5. Breathing in. 2, 3, 4, 5. Lock and hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. And lock and out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hold the breath out and lock the throat in. 3, 4, 5. One last cycle on your own. New ones can open your legs to relax it. Getting ready for Bhastrika after that. So it's perfectly fine to sit on a pillow. Practice is advanced. Really, this is intended for students practicing for 2 3 years. So any new ones, keep chilling in between. Bhastrika, strong in, strong out. Start on the nose. Slowly breathing in. All three locks hold the breath in. Unlock all the three locks and breathing out. And once you finish breathing out, lock again. The sound of Om. Lie down on your back in Shavasana. Slowly turning to one side. Come up to the sitting down position in the meditation position. Watching the breath moment to moment. It's a relaxed breath, it's a relaxed body. We're not controlling the breath, we're just watching it. And we're watching the breath, do watch the breath. There is nothing else that is going to happen. This is the point of it. Just being able to watch. If the soul, if the consciousness, it exists as now. And now is where you are watching the breath. Now is just another word for awareness. A teacher said it's not time. It's just another word for awareness. Now. What the breath is happening is now. going to slowly start to close the session. The sound of Om. Loving the palms, palms on the eyes, lie down on your back, lie down in Shavasana. Spend 4 to 5 minutes in Shavasana. Love you. Bye.